So this is exactly the project in which we will be working today on today's tutorial. I'm gonna show you how to do real-time license plate detection on a Raspberry Pi using an USB coral accelerator. And you can see that we are getting a very good detection, a very stable detection, and we are processing around 14 frames per second. So this is exactly the project of today's tutorial, and now let's get started. So the first step in this process is to connect to our Raspberry Pi. In my case, this is the command I'm going to execute in order to SSH into my Raspberry Pi. So I'm just going to press enter and I'm going to input my password like this. Okay, so I am already into my Raspberry Pi and I'm just going to cd into a directory I have created for this project, which is this one over here, License Plate Detection HDPU. And this is going to be pretty much all for now. Now, the next step in this process is to install the HDPU library into our Raspberry Pi, the HDPU runtime into the Raspberry Pi. You can see here, I'm showing you the coral.ai website. I'm showing you the documentation for the USB coral accelerator. And the only thing you need to do now is to go here to this section, install the HDPU runtime on Linux, and then the only thing you need to do is to execute all these commands over here. You can see you have three steps you need to follow in order to install this runtime in the Raspberry Pi. In my case, I have already installed all these commands you can see over here, so I'm not going to do it again, but in your case, please remember to do so before you continue. Now, the next step in this process will be to install the Pi Coral library. And this is very important. I'm going to show you how to do it. We are going to do it slightly different than you see over here. You can see that in the case of Linux, if you're using a Debian-based Linux system, including a Raspberry Pi, install Pi Coral as follows. But in my case, I tried to do it like this and I had some issues, I had some errors. So I found another way to do it, which works much better. Let me show you. The first thing I'm going to do is to create a virtual environment with Python 3.9. It's very important. It's a very old version of Python, actually, but this is the one we are going to use, because otherwise it will make the process slightly more challenging. So I'm just going to create a new virtual environment. I'm going to execute virtualenv bemp python 3.9. And then I'm going to activate this virtual environment. So you can see that over here in the documentation, it recommends to install the Pi Coral library like this with an apt-get install, right? But we are going to do it like this. We are going to execute this command over here, which is pip install extra index URL, and all these instructions you can see over here. Okay, now we're going to install another library, which is Ultralytics, because we are going to do object detection with YOLOv8, so we need to install the Ultralytics library, but this is very important. We are going to install a very specific version of the Ultralytics library, which is, let me find it, this one over here. We're going to install Ultralytics version 8.2.73. Now let me show you what's the Python script we will be using in order to detect license plates using our Raspberry Pi in our webcam. Let me show you. So this is the file we're going to use. You can see that the name is main.py. I have already produced this file, and this is the Python code we will be executing. This instruction over here, we are creating a new model. This is the object detector we will be using to detect license plates. And the only thing we are specifying over here is the location of the object detector, the model weights we will be using to detect license plates. And I'm going to tell you exactly how you can produce this file or how you can download this file later on this tutorial. But for now, just follow along. I'm going to explain all this file first, and then I'm going to tell you how you can download this file. You can see that over here we are creating this object which we are going to use in order to read frames from our webcam. In my case, I'm just going to use this number because I have only one webcam connected to my Raspberry Pi, but in your case you may want to choose another number, right? This depends on how many webcams you have connected to your Raspberry Pi and what's the webcam you want to use in this project, but in my case I'm just going to set this value in 0. Then over here you can see we are creating a new object which is called out, and we're going to be using this object in order to produce a new video with all the frames and all the bounding boxes on top, right? We will be detecting license plates on our webcam, and for every single one of these license plates we will be detecting, we are going to draw a bounding box on top of the frame. So this object over here is going to help us a lot in order to produce a new video with all the frames, with all the bounding boxes on top, right? This is going to be very useful. And you can see that we're creating this object with the same width and the same height of the webcam, right? You can see over here we are getting the width and the height of our webcam, and then we are just creating this object with the same width and the same height. And we are going to create this new video with 10 frames per second, because this is pretty much the same amount of frames per second we will be executing in this pipeline. Moving on, you can see that here we have a loop. We are going to be iterating in all the frames we get from the webcam. So as long as we get new frames from the webcam, we're just going to iterate over here. We're just going to keep on iterating in all the frames from the webcam. And for every single one of these frames, we are going to apply the object detector, and then we are going to iterate in all the detections we get from this object detector, right? You can see we are going to get this variable which is called output. Output is going to be the result of applying the object detector to this very specific frame, and then we are just iterating in all the bounding boxes we got in these results. Then over here we're just extracting all the information from the bounding box. This is the X and Y location of the bounding box, the upper left corner and the bottom right corner, right? Over here this is upper left, and over here this is bottom right. This is the confidence score of this particular detection, and this is the class ID, which in this case this is always going to be 0 because we're always detecting license plates. The only object we are detecting with this license plate detector is license plates. So this is always going to be the number 0. Then we are just going to continue with this part over here if the confidence score is greater than 0.6. In any other case, we are just going to continue with the next detection we got, right? This continue over here is going to break. This loop is going to break all this process, and it's just going to continue to the next iteration. And then we are just going to convert these values into integers, and then here is where we are going to draw the bounding box on top of the frame. You can see that the input is the frame, and then this is the upper left corner, and this is the bottom right corner, and this is the color of the bounding box we will be drawing on top of the frame. Then, in order to make it more clear that we have detected a license plate, we are also going to write license plate on top of the frame, on top of the detection we have drawn over here. And then, in order to make it clear how many frames per second we are processing in this from this webcam, we are also going to print the amount of frames per second we are executing over here, right? You can see that when we are starting this process, we are calling time.time. This is going to give us a number which is going to represent the current time, and then we are calling time.time again, so this is going to give us the exact time at which we are executing this command, and we are subtracting this over value over here, so the result will be how much time has passed in all this processing over here. Most of the time is going to be given here in the object detection, so this is going to be like a very good estimate of how much time it takes to process every single frame. And then we are taking 1 divided by this number, and this is going to give us the amount of frames per second we are getting currently at executing this frame. right? And that's pretty much all. So then once we have drawn the bounding boxes and the text and everything on top of the frame, the only thing we're going to do is to write this frame, and then that's pretty much all. Then we're just going to keep on iterating in all the frames we get from the webcam. So this is the script we will be executing in order to apply the license plate detector on all the frames from our webcam, right? You can see it's very simple, it's very straightforward, and this is pretty much all. Now, let me explain how you can produce this object detector you can see over here, which is very important because otherwise you will not be able to execute this process. So, there are two different ways in which you can produce this file. One of them, let me go over here. One of them is to produce this file yourself, and in order to do so, you will need to execute these three steps. The first one is to train an object detector to detect license plates using YOLOv8. This is going to produce a file in PyTorch format, which is going to be the object detector you will train by following this process, right? Then, once you have this object detector, you need to export a model to tf-little, right? You can do it using the same Ultralytics library you will be using in order to train the object detector, and this is going to produce a file in tf-little format. And then the next step in this process will be to compile model to HTPU. And this is going to produce another file in tf-little format, but this is going to be, let's call this HTPU tf-lit. Okay. So these are the three steps you need to execute in order to produce this file yourself. Now, in order to execute the first step in this process to train this object detector using YOLOv8, you can just go ahead and watch one of my previous videos where I show you the entire process of training an object detector using YOLOv8. In this video, oh my god, I show you absolutely every single detail that's involved in this process. So this part over here, you can just go ahead and do it yourself by watching that video over there. Now, the next step in this process is super straightforward, and the only thing you need to do is to use the Ultralytics library and to just call this function you can see over here. This is a Google Colab I created in order to export this file to tf-little, and you can see that the conversion actually is happening here. I am creating this object model, and the input is the license plate detector I trained with YOLOv8 in PyTorch 4. Format, right? You can see that the extension is .pt. This is the model weights of the model I trained in this step in this process. And then the only thing I'm doing after creating this object, which is called model, is calling model.export tf-little, and then these other two parameters over here, which are very important, the image size 320 and int 8 equal to true. This parameter over here is super important, amazingly important. This other over here, you could potentially play around with different values, but in order to achieve the same frames per second I'm going to show you in this video, it's better if you use the same value I'm using over here, which is 320. But long story short, the only thing you need to do is to just execute this command over here, and this is going to produce a new file, which is going to be the file you need over here, right? This file in tf-little format. So you can see that this is super easy, amazingly simple, and super, super simple and super easy to do. This is something you will be able to do by just executing these instructions. And then the next step in this process, compiling the model to HTPU, this is also going to be very straightforward because the only thing you need to do is to execute this command you can see over here. You need to call HTPU compiler and then the location of the model you are going to compile. And this is the model you are going to produce here in this step of this process. You can see in my case, you can see this file, the extension is tf-little, because this is a file I produced here when I was exporting the model to tf-little. This was a file I produced when I executed this command you can see over here. In this case, you can see it says 160, because when I was creating this file, I was experimenting with different image sizes, and this was a model I produced with an image size of 160, so that's why it says 160. But long story short, the only thing you need to do is to just call HTPU compiler, and then the input should be the location of the file you have produced over here when exporting the model to TF-Lidl format. And that's pretty much all. Once you have produced this file and you have located this file into your Raspberry Pi, the only thing you need to do is to just execute this script, and that's going to be pretty much all. So let me show you. I'm just going to leave this file over here, and I'm going to clear this terminal, and now I'm going to execute the script like this: Python main .pi. Okay, everything seems to be just fine. You can see we are starting the process, so this means we are iterating in all the frames we get from the webcam, and everything seems to be working just fine. So let me show you how it works, and I'm going to try to detect one of these license plates I have over here. These are a few license plates I have prepared in order to test this project. This is actually from one of the courses in the computer vision school, but it's going to be super helpful to test this project. So this is what I'm going to do. Okay, and the only thing I'm going to do is to point it to the camera for a few seconds. You can see that now we are hopefully we are detecting the license plate, and we are drawing the license plates on top of the frame and so on. So only a few seconds is going to be enough, so I can show you how it looks like, something like that. Okay, now I stopped the processing, and the only thing I'm going to do now, you can see we have saved this file we have produced over here in output.av, I don't know how to pronounce it. So the only thing I'm going to do is to copy this file into my computer. In order to do so, I'm going to execute the scp command, right? I'm going to scp this file, which is located here, into my computer, and let's see what happens. Okay, so this is the file we have produced. You can see that we're detecting 14 frames per second. And you can see that there we are detecting the license plate as we are approaching the camera, and the frames per second remain in around 14. And you can see it works pretty well. It's pretty stable. It's not enclosing the license plate like perfectly, but nevertheless, I will say it's working pretty well. Let's play it again over there. You can see we have a few misdetections, but we also have like a glare over there. Nevertheless, you can see that we are getting a few misdetections. There may be a few errors from once in a while, but we are getting a very good result, a very stable detection. We are detecting the license plates. It may not be like enclosing the license plate super accurately, but nevertheless, I really like what I see. I really like these results. And also take a look at the frames per second. We are getting 14 frames per second, in some cases 13, but nevertheless, this is a very good result too. So this is going to be all for this tutorial, and this is exactly how you can detect license plates on a Raspberry Pi using an USB Coral accelerator on your webcam.